See, alcohols mainly participate two types of reactions, two types of chemical reactions. OH bond breaking chemical reactions and CO bond breaking chemical reactions. So there, OH bond breaking chemical reactions examples already completed. Now, CO bond breaking chemical reactions. See, CO. So carbon oxygen between the bond breaking reactions. So alcohols participate CO bond breaking reactions. Examples, first one, reaction with hydrogen halides, HX. Reaction with hydrogen halides, that is one of the good example. So reaction with hydrogen halides. What are hydrogen halides? Hydrogen halides means C. So hydrogen halides, nothing but these are HI is more reactive than HBr, that is more reactive than HCl, C. So here, hydrogen halides, out of that, HI is more reactive than HBr, that is more reactive than HCl. Then, with respect to CO bond breaking, if you can take reactivity order of alcohols, alcohols are three types. What are that? Primary, secondary, and tertiary alcohols. Out of that, tertiary alcohols are more reactive than secondary. Secondary alcohols are more reactive than primary alcohols. This is the reactivity order of alcohols. Okay, then if any alcohol, that is nothing but either 1 degree or 2 degree or 3 degree, if it reacts with any hydrogen halide, HX, that is nothing but HCl, HBr, HI. Now in this process, see, here CO bond breaking cell takes place. Between alkyl and oxygen, the bond is breaking. Then here, OH combined with hydrogen replaced as a water. Then here, what form? Water form after that. R combined with X, we get RX. That is nothing but alkyl halide. Here we get the corresponding alkyl halide. Okay, see. Any alcohol reacts with any hydrogen halide, there we get corresponding alkyl halide. Okay, first one, the preparation of alkyl chlorides. Okay, reaction with HCl. So here, at the same time, I have given HCl is less reactive. Because of that reason, catalyst is required. Catalyst required. HCl is less reactive. We know that. See. So here, catalyst is required. That is anhydrous ZnCl2. That is called catalyst. Anhydrous ZnCl2. That acts as a catalyst. But here, if we can take HBr and HI. With respect to HBr and HI, compared to HCl, these are somewhat more reactive. So here, catalyst is not required. See this. catalyst not required. Only with respect to HCl, only catalyst is required due to the less reactive. Then, if alcohol, that is maybe 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree, whatever that. If it reacts with HCl in the presence of anhydrous ZnCl2. Okay, what is the mixture of this? At the same time, the mixture of HCl and anhydrous ZnCl2 is called Lucas reagent. This reagent is particularly called Lucas reagent. Okay, then here the CO bond breaking takes place. OH combine with hydrogen, replace as a H2O. Then we get alkyl chlorides. If we can take ethyl alcohol, we get ethyl chloride. Isopropyl alcohol, isopropyl chloride. Tertiary butyl alcohol, we get tertiary butyl chloride. So here at the same time, this reaction is used for, particularly, this reaction is used for the identification of type of alcohol. For example, in laboratory, they are given one alcohol, okay, to identify. Given alcohol is a, which type of alcohol? 1 degree, 2 degree, or 3 degree. So here immediately what we can do, what they are given alcohol, we take the one test tube. By adding some amount of Lucas reagent. What is called Lucas reagent? A mixture of HCl and anhydrous ZnCl2. So if here immediately to form turbidity. Turbidity is nothing but PPT, precipitate, like as a curd. Generally, alkyl chlorides are immiscible in Lucas reagent, not mixable, not soluble. Because of that reason here, to form turbidity. So if given alcohol is a 3-degree alcohol, 3-degree alcohols are more reactive. Because of that reason, immediately to form the turbidity. When we take the alcohol in one test tube by adding Lucas reagent, fraction of seconds we get turbidity. Fraction of seconds. Based on that, we can say given alcohol is a 3-degree alcohol, tertiary alcohol. Otherwise, if to form turbidity after some time, okay, few minutes. If it can take few minutes, based on that, we can say given alcohol is a 2-degree. Otherwise, it can take long time after heating only to form the turbidity. That is called tertiary alcohol. Okay, see, generally this test is also called Lucas test. What is the name of the test? Lucas test. What is the use of Lucas test? Based on Lucas test, we can say given alcohol type, 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree. Okay, see, here primary alcohols, 1 degree alcohol. Primary alcohol gives turbidity immediately. Okay, here approximate I have taken within fraction of seconds, just seconds here. Okay, now if we can take secondary alcohols give turbidity. So after some time. Okay, indirectly it can take few minutes. So here 3 degree alcohols are give turbidity immediately because it is more reactive. Now here if we can take 1 degree alcohols primary. Okay, these are give turbidity very long time. After a long time, after heating only, it can give the turbidity. After heating, generally, so it can take just I have taken hours difference scale area. See, Now, based on this test, we can say given alcohols are which type of alcohols? Given alcohols are either 1 degree or 2 degree or 3 degree. We can say based on this Lucas test. Clear it is? Suraksha. Understood? Lucas test. Jahanavi. Okay. Good. Now see, that is the use of Lucas test. Okay, then. So if we can take the HBR. So generally, with respect to HBR, I have given just one thing here. Alizander rate is stable. HBR is unstable. HBR is unstable. So what? Unstable compounds are takes in situ conditions. So it takes in situ conditions. Situ conditions. Okay, what are situ conditions indirectly? For example, see, alcohol, ROH. Okay, we want the reaction with HBr. Now here, so HBr does not take place directly. Why? Because it is unstable. So it takes indirectly, see, it takes like as a NaBr, sodium bromide, and HCl or H2SO4, whatever that, both are same there, no problem. So when we take this mixture, now here H combined with Br, we get HBr. H combined with Br, we get HBr. So this mixture produces the HBr, remaining NaCl, it is the salt, generally it is not affected the reaction. So this is says what we can situ conditions. Now according to rule here, CO bond breakings are takes place. OH combined with hydrogen replaced as a water. Okay, then what we get? R combined with Br, RBr, alkyl bromides. Now. So if you can take HI, hydrogen iodide. Okay, here hydrogen iodides are more reactive. Because of that reason, the reaction takes place directly. So the alcohol, any type of alcohol, see ROH, I have taken ROH, this is nothing but alcohol. It reacts with hydrogen iodide. Here CO bond breaking cell takes place. So here OH combined with hydrogen replaced as a H2O. Okay, then what we get? R combined with RI. It is called alkyl iodide. Alkyl iodide. See this? Alkyl iodide. So this is the reaction with hydrogen halides. It is an example of CO bond breaking. Now, see, if next one, reaction with phosphorus halides. Reaction with phosphorus halides means generally phosphorus combines with halogen. There we get two types of halides, phosphorus trihalides and phosphorus pentahalides. Phosphorus trihalides mean PCl3, phosphorus trichloride, that is the stable. But PBr3, Pi3 unstable. So unstable compounds are takes in situ conditions, first of all. Okay, then if we can take phosphorus pentahalides, phosphorus trihalides are nothing but PX3 and PX5 series. PX3 and PX5, phosphorus trihalide and phosphorus pentahalide, PX5. Now, so phosphorus trihalides means, what is the good example? PCl3. Okay, if we can take PBr3, Pi3, no problem. But there PBr3 and Pi3 unstable, that compounds are takes in situ condition. Just that is only, remaining everything same. Now, if, so alcohol, if I have taken ethyl alcohol, see this C2H5OH. So reacts with the PCl3. Say, what are the products here? Anyone? Already these are given in halogen derivatives. Ethyl alcohol reacts with PCl3. What we get? Here also CO bond breaking side takes place. OH place may what we get? Chlorine. Now here we get C2H5Cl. Ethyl chloride. Ethyl alcohol is ethyl chloride. Isopropyl alcohol, isopropyl chloride. Tertiary butyl alcohol, tertiary butyl chloride. That's all. Now, then, what is the byproduct there? S3PO3. Phosphorus acid. Phosphorous acid. So this is the reacts with the PCl3. Otherwise, if we can take PBr3, same here Br. Pi3, here I. Remaining everything same. Just we take the PBr3, Pi3 in situ conditions from red phosphorus and bromine, red phosphorus and iodine. Now, balance for equation here. How many chlorines are there? 3 chlorines. Here, 3 moles. Here, 3 moles. Now, everything balanced. Okay. Otherwise, see, if same C2H5OH, ethyl alcohol, reacts with PCl5. Say that. What are the products? Phosphorus pentachloride. Now say, what are the products? Phosphorus pentachloride. What are the products? There also which breakings are takes place? CO bond breakings are takes place. OH place, what we get? Cl, C2H5Cl plus. Byproducts are different. What are the byproducts there? POCl3 and HCl. POCl3 and HCl. These are the byproducts. Okay. Already equation balanced. There you go. If we can take ethyl alcohol, we get ethyl chloride. Isopropyl alcohol, isopropyl chloride. Tertiary butyl alcohol, we get tertiary butyl chloride. Now, if same ethyl alcohol, if it reacts with SOCl2, what about SOCl2? Thionyl chloride. There is nothing but sulfuryl chloride. At that time, I have given this method is better than other two methods. This process is better than other two processes. The preparation of alkyl chlorides. Why? Because, what is the reason? Why it is better? How to say that? So, how to say that? Say, there also CO bond breakings are takes place. we get C2H5Cl plus. If you are observed byproducts, here we get HCl gas byproduct and SO2 gas byproduct. Here, both byproducts are gaseous state byproducts. So what? The gaseous state byproducts are easily removed from the reaction mixture. These are easily escaped from the experiment. So because of that reason, this method is better than other methods. At the same time, this reaction takes place in the presence of pyridine also. Pyridine. Here, pyridine is a base. Pyridine. It is a basic nature substance, base. Here, HCl is an acid. SO2 also acid. The pyridine, it neutralizes the both byproducts. Neutralizes because pyridine is a base, HCl is an acid, SO2 also acid. So it will easily neutralizes the base. Neutralizes. So it is the better method than other methods. The preparation of alkyl chlorides. Okay, write down. So complete our 2 minutes. Understood? Board clear na?
Yes, sir.
Okay, voice, board, everything clear?
Yes, sir.
Good. So Lucas test used what about the for the identification of type of alcohol. If laboratory there, okay, they are given one alcohol here. Just they are given alcohol. This is one person. Given alcohol is which type of alcohol? Identify that. So alcohol mein 3 types are there. 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree. So very easy. What they are given alcohol, we take one test tube. Test tube mein lena padta hai. By adding directly Lucas reagent. So what is called Lucas reagent? So HCl and anhydrous ZnCl. This mixture is called Lucas reagent. Okay, immediately if you are observed, PPT is nothing but PPT. It is look like dahi. Curd kaisa rehta, aisa rehta. If you form immediately turbidity, seconds, we can say that is a 3 degree alcohol. Why? Because tertiary alcohols are more reactive. So it can give immediately turbidity. Agar nahi to, okay, after some time, okay, after shaking, few minutes, if you form the turbidity, that is called 2 degree alcohol. Otherwise, it can take long time. That is called primary alcohol. So based on that, we can say given alcohols are which type of alcohol, primary or secondary or tertiary. Complicated. So fast, complete the building. Then I will give you next equation, dehydration process.
Done, sir.
Okay, good. Remaining students. Aditya, completed. Atharva.
Done, sir.
Okay, good. Otherwise, take the screenshot. right? So now listen, next example, most important example, dehydration of alcohols. That is also example of OH CO bond breaking only, CO bond breaking like this only. Okay, dehydration of alcohols, or simply dehydration. Okay, see. So here, dehydration of alcohols. So here, what is called dehydration of alcohols? Now here, D means removal. D, removal. Removal of water molecule from the alcohols is called dehydration of alcohols. So removal of water molecule from the alcohol, D, removal. Removal of water. So with respect to dehydration of alcohols, if you are observed, the reactivity order is 3 degrees greater than 2 degree, 2 degrees greater than 1 degree alcohols. This is the reactivity order. At the same time, so dehydration of alcohol. If you can take one example, see. So if you can take example alcohols, it is CH3, CH2OH. If I have taken alcohol, it is nothing but ethanol. Ethyl alcohol here, okay, whatever that, 1 degree or 2 degree or 3 degree, anyone, no problem. Take alcohol here. Now, dehydration. Dehydration means removal of water. For removing water, generally we can take the dehydrating agents. Which chemical substance to absorb water molecule from the given compound? That is called dehydrating agent. Which chemical substance to absorb, to remove water molecule? That is called dehydrating agents. Okay, the main important dehydrating agents are concentrated H2SO4. It is one of the best dehydrating agent. Not only that, second one, P2O5, phosphorus pentoxide, otherwise Al2O3, alumina, that is nothing but aluminum oxide, or H3PO4, phosphoric acid. Okay, these all are behave like as a dehydrating agents. Dehydrating, D, removal, hydrating water molecule. These are remove the water molecule from the given substance. So these are acts as a dehydrating agents. So concentrated H2SO4, P2O5, Al2O3, H3PO4, these are the dehydrating agents. Now listen, when we take these dehydrating agents, see. Now here, OH combined with here H. Generally, OH bonded carbon alpha. Here, alpha referred first carbon, first rank. That is the meaning. First rank, OH bonded carbon, first rank, alpha. Next one, second rank, beta. Next, gamma, like this, 1, 2, 3 ranks. Okay, in this dehydration process, immediately these agents are absorbed. Water molecules. So how to absorb, see this? OH combine with H, which hydrogen that is most important? Beta hydrogen always. Any one of the beta hydrogen out of three, no problem. OH minus and H plus replaced as a water, H2O. That is called dehydration of alcohol. Given alcohol, we remove the water molecule by using dehydrating agent. Okay, then between alpha beta carbons required double bond for tetravalency ke liye double bond hona. Now see this bond moving like as a double bond here CH, then H here double bond CH H. We get here ethene. That is nothing but alkene, ethene. So always in dehydration of alcohols process, the alcohols are converted into alkenes, corresponding alkenes after loss of water molecule. That is called dehydration. Now one more thing. So one more thing, if so I have taken say this CH3, CH2, CHOH, CH3. Now here I have taken concentrated H2SO4. Okay, it is a dehydrating agent. We know about that. So it absorbs the water molecule from the alcohol. Now which products are formed? Say OH bonded carbon, what I have given? It is a alpha. Next carbon, okay, right side, it is a beta, it is also beta. Then gamma like that. So here alpha carbon bonded carbons are called beta, right side on beta, left side on beta. Beta carbon bonded hydrogens are called beta hydrogens. Now here two chances are there. If this OH minus combines with this hydrogen, okay, right side beta hydrogen. Okay, that is removed as a water molecule. Okay, water molecule removed here. Then between alpha beta, what we get? Double bond. See that CH3, CH2. Now CH double bond CH2. We get here 1-butene alkene. Okay, not only that. Okay, if I have replaced left side beta hydrogen, this one, this is also beta hydrogen. Now if we can replace it here hydrogen, between this alpha beta we get double bond, that is called 2-butene. Because of that reason here we get, see this, so this alkene, it is called 2-butene. Okay, in this case we get two products, 1-butene and 2-butene. So here out of two products, which is the major product? That says it is the major product. So how to take that is the major product? So that can says before I have given according to Segev rule. Segev's rule. According to Segev rule, we can take the major product. What is called Segev rule? See, with respect to alpha carbon, which side number of carbons are more? That side beta hydrogen eliminated product is the major product. With respect to this alpha, right side one carbon, left side two carbons. Which side number of carbons are more? That side beta hydrogen eliminated product is the major. Which side? Left side. This beta hydrogen. This beta hydrogen is eliminated. We get which product? 2-butene. That is called Segev rule. This process is also called, I have given, beta elimination process. Beta elimination process. This is also referred as a beta elimination process. So beta hydrogen eliminated here. So that is called beta elimination process. Okay. If you can say here, observed mechanism. So generally, this dehydration of alcohol's mechanism takes place through three steps. So mechanism takes place through three steps. Step one, sink. The formation of protonated alcohol. The formation of protonated alcohol. What is the meaning of that? Very simple, see. Okay, if I have taken ethyl alcohol, see this. It is nothing but CH3 and CH2OH. Here oxygen having two lone pairs are present according to rule. Now it combines with H plus. It is nothing but proton. This H plus coming from acid. We use the sulfuric acid, it releases the H plus ions. So this H plus now slowly it reacts on oxygen. We get the corresponding product. Protonated alcohol. Alcohol reacts with the proton. H plus is also called proton. It gives the acid. Now we get protonated alcohol. See this? CH3. Then CH2 as it is.